Thanks for checking out the Meguiar Chevrolet Cadillac Highlight of the Week. We support the community we serve. Visit us when you're ready for a newer pre-owned car. Maximize your fuel economy today with the Chevy Cruze. 592 miles between fill-ups and 42 miles per gallon.
This match starts at 113. James Elphick of Kittatinny with the back points on his way to a major over John Torpe of High Points, and that makes the score 4-0 Kittatinny. 120 pound weight class we go. Mike Darren of High Point with a reversal. He beat Dave Popick 11-4 to make the team score 4-3 Kittatinny. 126, Chris Auer of High Point with the back points. He came back to win a major over Kevin Jelnick. It's now 7-4 High Point in front of Kittatinny.
Usually, most people go down in the first period. They usually don't come back in the match. Not with me. I'm always coming back. I'm always fighting, scoring points. I got it in my head just to keep scoring, and you know, it just worked.
132, Jason Gashion of High Point and Tom Murphy of Kittatinny had a great battle. Gashion with the ultimate ride out to make the team score 10-4 High Point. 138, Jason Snyder of Kittatinny with a takedown. He won 5-1 over Nick Romines to make the score 13-4. High Point now leads Kittatinny. 145, Kittatinny's Clark Moynihan with the fall over Moses Yassin of High Point. Kittatinny closes the gap. They now trail High Point 13-10. 152 we go. Alec Alvino of High Point with the back points. He won a major decision over Brandon Olson of Kittatinny. It's now 17-10 High Point.
Yeah, I knew we had to keep it rolling. I mean, we need the momentum to keep it going in a match. And I came out looking to get some bonus points, and I got some.
160. Kieran Garrity of Kittatinny, 3 back points. He goes on to score an 8-2 decision over Antonio for a speed of High Point. It's now 17-13 High Point leads Kittatinny. 170. Kevin Pettinger of High Point with a reversal. He beat Jake Brook of Kittatinny 4-3. 20-13, High Point now leads Kittatinny.
I didn't want him let him take control of the match. I wanted to be in positions where I was comfortable. I was comfortable in ties, on the mat. I mean, yeah, you saw I got in some scary situations there. But it was just, you just got to adapt and overcome.
On to 182, Kyle Stoll of High Point with a takedown on Garrett Armstrong of Kittatinny. He won 5-1. It's now 23-13, High Point.
Just going out there and do what I had to be done, and you know, just we've been training hard in the room and just working hard. So just went out there and wrestled how I know how to wrestle.
195, Dylan Wonder of Kittatinny gets the back points and a major decision over Drew Bai of High Point. Kittatinny now trails 23-17. 220, Jake Drelick of Kittatinny had Gunther Watson on his back a few times. He got several back points in this match. He won by major. 23-21, High Point now leads. 285, here it goes, folks. It takes 40 seconds for Chris Epperly to pin Tom Smith, and that seals the win for High Point. They go up 29-21. And the match ends at 106. Dom Gallo of High Point with the back points. He beat Christian Silva of Kittatinny. The final score, 32-21.
It was a huge match. I mean, we haven't lost to Kittatinny in a while, and we definitely didn't want to lose this year. We wanted to keep the tradition rolling of beating them, and I think we took care of that tonight.
Well, it means a lot, because those kids that were sitting on the side, that used to be me. A couple years ago, I would always be watching. I'd be watching the big kids, and I'd think, that's going to be me someday, and that's me now. So I was proud of myself to come through and get a win.
It means a ton. I mean, you saw how this is just as packed as it was for Long Branch, and the fans love it. They come out here, and like everyone's rooting for each other. Everyone's cheering their loudest for the person that's on the mat at the given time. But to me personally, it's awesome, because it's always the Sussex County's biggest rivalry going back for years and years. And it's like, I mean, obviously it's nice to come out on top, and there has to be a winner and a loser. But for me, being away, it's really nice touch to my senior year.
Kids did a great job being able to, you know, come in and perform the way they did against Kittatinny. And, you know, you look at a match like this, and a lot of times it's not about the wins. It's, you know, it's about the kids that got beat and the effort they put in. And you know, you can't be successful unless you have 14 quality kids that go out there. And tonight all 14 of our kids wrestled well.
And talking about the experience of being in front of the big crowd here, you know, not something that you maybe have had a lot of experience with. You did have some big bounce as a freshman, but, you know, coming back and having the packed gym, how did that make you feel?
As a freshman, I didn't see any crowds like this. But it just adds like 100 pounds onto your shoulders on top of it being High Point versus Kittatinny. So you're thinking out there, you're thinking there's no way I can lose. There's no way I can lose this match. And it's just like, it's who wants it more? Who can score more points?
Talk about what it means to be a senior. You know, a lot of people said, Alec, and we talked about this after the Newton match, oh, High Point's done, they're done. Well, you know what? You made a pretty good statement here tonight that is not true.
Yeah, we're definitely not done. But being a senior, it's important to keep the young guys focused. I mean, a lot of times they get distracted, they get nervous, but we're there, we keep them going and make sure their heads are in the right place.
Coach Gardner, have to say anything to you guys this week to get you ready, play the underdog role a little bit, or not needed?
I don't think anyone in the room thought we were the underdogs today. We all thought we'd come out and take care of business. But, yeah, he just said to go out and have fun because these are the days that we're going to look back when we're older and say, hey, that was fun.
He let us work on, you know, moves that we think would help us this match, counters and everything, but same practices and, you know, just going hard in the room.
You're talking about some of those efforts that you had. Chris Auer, at the end of the first period, he's down 4-0. He gets stuck on his back out of bounds. And for a lot of kids, that probably would have defeated him. He came back and rattled off 15 straight points.
Yeah, he's a really neat kid because he's doing a good job this season. He's wrestling well. Sometimes it takes him a little while to get going, and but he doesn't panic and he doesn't get frustrated, and you know he just keeps coming and does his thing, and I'm glad it worked out for him.
You had a big return in Jason Snyder tonight. Gashion, your nephew, had a nice win at 132. It allowed you to kind of set that match up. And just talk about him taking the mat there and getting a big win over Nick Romans.
You know, Jason's a quality kid, and certainly we're happy to have him back in our lineup. Adding him to our room and now our team, it's had a nice impact on our kids and the way they work and what some of our expectations are.
We talked about this after the Newton match. You know, how did you change your approach this year? And you said you really went to great pains to not change your approach, to coach this team the same way that you had coached the last 4 years. And that has seemed to have a very positive impact on these kids. Chris Auer even talked about it. You know, now I'm one of those big kids. I have to step up the way that those kids that graduated last year did. Do you think that's really contributed to the growth of your young wrestlers who really came up big in this match?
You know, I hope in some way. I hope, you know, being able to watch those kids compete and perform last year and then what they went through to be successful, I hope, you know, some of that did rub off on these guys. You know, obviously it's a brand new group, but they're quality kids and they're able to wrestle. You know, if you take a look at, you know, where we started this season and you know, I've said all along we still have a ways to go, but we're getting a little bit closer than we were when we started. So, you know, I it's fun. It's fun to go to work every day and you know, see the kids improve and see the kids get a little bit better. And, you know, as they improve and progress, you know, they want to be that much better. And, I'm just happy to be a part of it.
Now, talk about from here, moving on with the rest of the season, how this kind of sets you up for the rest of your year.
I think it was nice. This was like a big atmosphere setting, and I think it was good because we're going to need to get used to that coming into groups and sectionals.
It's a huge step. There was a, we have a checklist that we're working on, and this was the second step. So, you know, now we just got to move on to groups and districts and all the other fun stuff we got waiting.